Hey everyone, welcome back to Six Wins. My name is Matt and I'm here with Chris again, and we are going over more results from our best male actor bracket voted on by you guys on our Twitter and on our Instagram profiles right now. And we're going to talk about a couple matchups in this video. We're going to go through about three that we had results for. The first one we're going to talk about is going to be our 7 seed Bradley Cooper versus our 10 seed John Malkovich. Let me kick it off really quick with a thought that I had on this one. Yeah. Everything in my heart and soul told me like John Malkovich is probably the better actor, but I figured Bradley Cooper would win. I voted for Bradley Cooper. I think it's a maybe like what have I seen you in lately? Bradley Cooper, super handsome, in a lot of really popular things, Hangover, Limitless, things like that. I think he maybe got a really good draw for a 10 seed. Some of the other 10 seeds are a bit stronger than Malkovich, a bit more popular. But how about you? What do you think about this matchup?
Yeah, so this one kind of came down to a popularity contest. I think, full transparency, I don't think I've ever seen a full John Malkovich movie. So I've seen tons of Bradley Cooper, and I think as our channel, because we're brand new, as of this recording, we've been doing this for 6 days. So we're still new. So I think as we grow, the votes will show that we'll get more takes, we'll get more people voting, you know, it'll be more, because right now it's a lot of like our friends and our demographic. Probably gonna go Cooper. I would probably go Cooper, just biased. But yeah, movies you mentioned, Hangover, hilarious. Wedding Crashers as Zach, hilarious.
Oh, for sure.
And
yeah.
Limitless makes me feel like I'm on Adderall every single time. Like I feel like I'm invincible. But yeah, I'm going Cooper. I don't really have much else to add.
Did the poll shake out the same way? Or did
it
surprise? It didn't,
Bradley Cooper won, kind of a landslide in the polls. But
yeah. Like we said, that matchup just kind of seemed like a popularity contest. It seemed like Malkovich had an uphill battle despite all his talent. The next one we're going to talk about is our number 6 seed, Anthony Hopkins, Sir Anthony Hopkins, versus our 11 seed, Gary Oldman. Do you want to kick off your thoughts first on this one?
I don't have much, honestly. Hopkins, I'm going Hopkins. And no one else has said it. The only thing I've seen Gary Oldman in is Shameless and Jurassic Park 3. And he's fine. He's great.
Yeah, this is a hard one for me because I know Gary Oldman's reputation. And it's a really solid like acting reputation. He does a lot of character roles. He really transforms. But I don't know if I've ever seen a lot of his films and really been like, you know, this is a favorite film or favorite performance. Mm-hmm. Likewise, I haven't seen that much Anthony Hopkins, of course, in Silence of the Lambs, most famously. that's beautiful.
That was my impression of Lloyd Christmas from Dumb and Dumber doing his impression. I've never seen it.
There you go.
Also, I'll chime in. If you're ever Googling Gary Oldman, make sure you don't forget the R in Gary.
Thank you. That's a good tip. That is a good tip.
Yeah. Different results will come up.
But the one thing, and the one again, I'm torn here because I think Oldman might be a better actor, but Anthony Hopkins is a really solid actor. But the one thing that I've seen Anthony Hopkins in is the TV show Westworld. And he's not a major role, but he's in the first season, which is the best season. You might argue the only good season. It definitely fell off. It was my favorite show for a while. And his performance in that is phenomenal. And for that reason alone, I would pick him. But obviously, he's got the credentials in all of his other films to beat out Oldman. So I think, I would vote Hopkins as well.
Hopkins won.
Hopkins did win.
Hopkins won.
So Hopkins is moving on. Yeah. And he is actually going to face the winner of our next matchup we're going to talk about. This is our last one for the video. We're going to talk about our number 5. Philip Seymour Hoffman versus our number 12, Miles Teller.
Well, I'm going to let you close this out. So I got a quick thing to say. I believe in my soul that three people were born to act. Peter Dinklage was born to act. Glenn Howerton, Dennis from Always Sunny, born to act. And Philip Seymour Hoffman, born to act. And I can't say it in words, but to me, just observing them, they have an intangible. So for me, Philip Seymour Hoffman, but I will say Miles Teller is the man. Unfortunately, he got placed against one of my favorites of all time. Top Gun Maverick is the best movie I've ever seen in my entire life. I'm going out on a limb and saying that. And I think
that's a hot take.
Right, that's a hot take. But I saw it in theaters 3.5 times. Well, four times. One of them was for free at the gym I go to. They have like a cinema in there. But I just can't get enough of that movie, and he rocked it. So I'll pass it over to you. That's my take. I would go Hoffman.
I can't disagree. Like there's something when I think about Philip Seymour Hoffman and his roles, like just really high art words come to mind. Like just true thespian, like describes Philip Seymour Hoffman for me. Like he is just like that old school classic actor that just, you know, is talented and just has like a subtlety to all of his performances.
Right.
He doesn't have to be over the top to just nail it. Mm-hmm. My personal favorite movie that he's been in is Magnolia.
Oh.
And he's really solid in that one. He also did win a Best Actor award for his role as Truman Capote. So he's won the Best Actor. So he obviously has that kind of experience. He's also in Hunger Games for some of you. You probably have seen him in that.
Big Lebowski.
I agree with you. Miles Teller, like, I think he's just too new, too young. Mm-hmm. Time will tell for him. I think he will have a lot of success. But I would also go Hoffman. And what was the results of that one?
The results were Hoffman. Philip Seymour Hoffman. Moving on to face the winner
Oh, I got it wrong.
That's all right.
Yeah. I talked about somebody going up against the next round, Cooper and Malkovich. Yeah, they're not going up against Philip Seymour Hoffman. Don't worry about it.
More to come.
Yeah.